Welcome to this week's episode of the DevOps Lab. I have a very special guest with us, Christos Matzkos. Welcome, Christos.
Nice to be here.
Good to have you here.
Thank you. Finally.
I know. We're finally back in the studio. Very exciting episode. And we're kicking off a whole new series on identity for developers. So in this first episode, we're going to talk about identity and why we should care about it as a developer and how we're going to integrate it into DevOps. So Christos, tell us why as a developer I need to be concerned about identity.
Developer, ops, IT admin, everyone needs to be concerned with security because it's such an important topic. Mm-hmm. And it's hard to get. It's not exciting. Not many people get excited about security. And unfortunately, what we see is people making the news for their own reasons. So we want to make sure that everyone falls in the pit of success when it comes to building secure apps that run everywhere.
Yeah, and it's kind of that whole thing of shifting security left, doing things early and often. So as a developer, what do I need to be thinking about? Like, I hear this thing called Azure AD. I have ops teams telling me I need it, but they usually do it for me. So how do we navigate that?
It depends on the size of the team, obviously, because in some teams, developers do everything. In bigger organizations, you have ops teams and clear separation of concerns, but everybody has to work together. Mm-hmm. Shifting left is all about bringing security earlier in the development process, part of the planning experience, and making sure that developers don't do silly things like putting secrets in the code, or trying to access resources that are not secured, or leaving storage accounts open to everyone with public access. So, and then sometimes ops will do that, right? They will create a storage account, they forget to lock it down, and everybody can access it.
And I've done it. I know we've all kind of done it. I've left a secret in plain text file, like on a server, because I was doing something like rushing and I'm going to get it done, and I left a secret out. So we need to get rid of that. Definitely, and eradicate that behavior, because we know about 95% of cloud breaches are due to human error.
Correct.
And stuff like that, plain text passwords.
Yeah.
So
we're making everyone's lives easier by, we're making the bad people's lives easier by being
lazy. Leaving them open doors.
Yeah.
So can you kick off and tell us what is Azure AD? And I think there's a few different types, and I'm always a little fuzzy on the different types. Can you walk us through those?
Yeah. Azure Active Directory is a cloud service identity and access management service. If you are running on Azure or you have Microsoft 365, you already have an Azure Active Directory. It can be used for securing apps, like sign-in, sign-outs, getting tokens for your APIs. But from a DevOps perspective, it can also be used to secure your CI/CD pipelines. It can be used to eliminate secrets from your applications using a combination of services and tools and accounts. But it's very powerful. The whole point here is that you cannot do much without identity and Azure Active Directory in place. And we want to showcase how easy it is to set it up and get started.
Awesome. And I think there's a few different kinds. So I've used service principles before.
Yes.
I've heard of managed identities. I think I've used them. But can you walk us through the different types, the kind of key pillars of Azure AD?
Yeah, there are three key pillars, right? Mm-hmm. So service principles are your cloud service accounts. They allow you to build apps that can access resources through an authenticated context. It's an account, in effect, that allows you to access resources. It's good because it enables a lot of scenarios, can be locked down, but at the same time, it's a secret and a username and a password. So again, you need to be very careful about how you store them, how you deal with them. They expire.
They do expire.
They create a whole mess when things happen like that. Mm-hmm. So the next best thing is a managed identity, which is, again, another Azure Active Directory backed object that allows service-to-service communication.
Okay.
Easy peasy, without having to have any credentials. Azure Active Directory manages the credentials, and the services get a token and validate the token behind the scenes. So very easy to work with.
Okay.
And then the third one, which is a very new addition to the pillars, the third one is the workload federated identity. This is an option to allow you to get an authenticated context outside of Azure.
Okay.
Because that's the key, service principles and managed identities work very well in Azure.
Mm-hmm.
Once you extend and you need to do hybrid,
right,
then that's where the problem starts. That's why workload federated identity was invented.
Awesome. So we have service principles, which I've certainly used. They've expired. Someone leaves the organization and you're kind of stuffed.
Correct.
So like to avoid those. Mm-hmm. We've had managed identities, which I've used before as well.
Yep.
And then we're going to talk about workload identity federation. So we're going to talk about a lot of identity stuff, securing apps, doing things in CI/CD pipelines, doing stuff with infrastructure as code. We're going to cover all of it.
Absolutely.
Awesome.
I love exciting stuff.
Cool. Well, everyone, stay tuned for episode 2, where we're going to be covering off more identity for developers and throughout this entire series. So tune in to learn more about identity.